Hey, I know that you're either an athlete or a sports coach who wants to master the inner game of greatness. And I'm asking you to play along here and pretend, just real quick, pretend that you're a professional tennis player on the world tour and you're in a quarterfinal and it's a very important game for you. And you're going out there, you're playing really well, you're winning the first set and things are going well. But then in the second set, you double fault on your serve and you start talking to yourself and you're like, damn, how could I miss this easy shot? Right? And then it happens again. You're going, damn, I'm really making stupid mistakes today. And then your train of thought, and you can't even blink with your eyes. It goes so fast. It goes from, I'm making stupid mistakes today to I'm shooting badly today to I'm a bad shooter to I'm a bad player to I'm no good. Right? And what does that do to your confidence? It is absolutely detrimental. And here's the thing, it is frustrating to know what you're truly capable of, but not being able to perform under pressure, not being able to perform when it really counts, not being able to perform when the world is watching, you know, when there's something on the line. It's very frustrating and quite frankly, it sucks because it makes us question ourselves. It makes us question if we're on the right track. It makes us question if this is all worth it. But you know what it means? It just means that you haven't learned how to handle your emotions. That's what it means. And the good news is, the beautiful news is that when you look, these shifts from playing a stellar game, a stellar competition, to going, like, to making so many easy and stupid mistakes, to being nervous, to buckling under pressure, these shifts happen immediately. Right? So what that means is that is proof that it's all mental. It has nothing to do with your physical skills. It has nothing to do with your technical skills. It has nothing to do with your strategical skills. It has nothing to do with your nutrition. It is all here. And the shifts are instantaneous and immediate. And how cool is that? Right? That's so beautiful because you're going to get results so fast when you learn to quiet your mind and when you're winning the inner game of greatness. Okay. And I want you to imagine an environment that you create because you're powerful. You can do that, that you create where it's safe for you to fail. And when it's safe for you to fail, you're not trying so hard. And when you're not trying so hard, you're going into flow states. You are going to be very present. Your mind is going to be quiet. And you're going to be so relaxed, yet super focused at the same time. And that's what peak performance is. You're going to be like a freaking lion. I mean, how beautiful is he? You're going to be like a lion, like sitting in the bush, about to jump out and attack a freaking zebra. Relaxed, yet super focused at the same time. And it's all very, very natural. So, you know, I feel blessed, lucky, grateful because I have managed to perform under pressure. I went from being scared from swimming, believe me or not, right? I was scared and anxious and all that, jumping in a pool, to going and swimming a Swiss record at the Olympic Games in London 2012 with a lot of pressure. But also, and I'm very proud of that, I've helped athletes on all levels from an Olympic champion all the way to executives who fancy a competitive tennis match in quieting their mind and preparing the grounds for frequent and consistent peak performance experiences. There's only one way to perform better under pressure, and that eliminates confusion. And that one way is to quiet your mind. Okay. And how are we going to get there? We got to take a very holistic approach, a very hands-on approach, a very, experiential approach, an implementation heavy approach, because these done for you models, they don't work. They're the biggest joke out there because when is the last time you paid a strength coach to put on some muscle for you? When is the last time you paid a nutritionist to eat some vegetables for you? When is the last time you paid somebody to fix your marriage? It doesn't freaking work because you cannot outsource the development and the growth of your mindset. And you hear me talk about growth and development a lot. And I'll tell you why, because I'm not so much interested in the level of mental skills that you have right now. What I'm interested in is in your rate of change, in your rate of improvement. Because when you're learning every day, when you're learning more than everybody else every day, you're creating that exponential growth curve for yourself. And even though the effects of the mental game are immediate and instantaneous, the mastery of these skills will still take some time. So the faster we can learn, the faster we're going to get there. Can we establish that? Do you agree with me? The faster we learn, the faster we're going to reach our goals, right? And it's not so much about where you are today than it is about how you're going to move forward and what pace you're going to move forward. So it's very important that we create this accelerated learning environment. And here I want to offer you an important analogy. How are we going to do that? Now, this is gold. So I don't have a kid yet, but I'm going to be looking down. Got to talk to my girlfriend, hopefully soon. But kids, they learn the most incredible things effortlessly, effectively, very naturally, like languages and learning how to walk. And I want to take the example of how to walk. So we're about 1 year old, right? And the first thing that we do is like we look at our parents and we create a mental image of the desired outcome. We want to get off our knees and we want to start walking and we just try. And we fail and we correct and we fail and we correct. We fail, correct until it's perfect, right? And there's a secret sauce to creating the learning, the accelerated learning environment, and that is the absence of judgment. Because when the baby learns to walk, the parents don't judge the baby. It's like, oh, Joanna, you're a bit slow. You should be knowing that by now, right? We don't do that. And also, very importantly, the baby doesn't judge itself. In the absence of judgment, love can emerge. So there's love from the parents, there's self-love, and there's no judgment. And that creates the accelerated learning environment, because when there's no judgment, you are free to fail. It's okay to make a mistake, right? And that's what we want, because as you're not trying so hard because you're allowed to fail, you're going to go into flow states. When you go into flow states, you're going to be present. You're going to quiet your mind and you're going to be very relaxed and focused at the same time. So how are we going to implement that in our world? So you can learn to quiet your mind and perform under pressure and being seen when it really counts, okay? What if I told you that I'm gonna let you leverage all of my knowledge, all of my experience, and my entire support system every single week? What if I told you that I'm gonna give you the exact steps on how to create a powerful mental image of your desired outcome? What if I give you all the visualization exercises and drills that you can use every single day? What if I gave you the exact steps on how to suspend self-judgment? What if I give you the exact steps on how to observe what's obvious and then how to improve without judging yourself again and again and again? You know, this, what if I went live every single week and I'll teach you one concept and one group exercise that we're gonna do, because it's so hands-on, because I'm all about you having the experience, because that's when you're learning. When you're having the experience, you are very likely to implement, and that's what I'm interested in. What if I go live every single week with a question and answers where I'll answer any question that you have, because I don't want you to be stuck. I want you to move forward. I want you to be clear on where you're going. What if I gave you all the resources that I've gathered over the years from thousands of books and podcasts and videos and courses, and I'll just give them to you when I feel that would be helpful to you to move forward? What if I, and this is so cool, what if I, I'm really good at motivating, you'll see. What if I get you to journal your transformation with 5 minutes every day? If I get you to journal your transformation, how you're going from mentally being, let's say, challenged to mental, you know, to thriving for mental greatness, okay? Just that in itself is going to be so cool. But hey, look, is it going to take some time? Yes. Is it going to be a commitment? Yes. Is it going to be uncomfortable? It can be, Yes, but that's the cool thing. You, as athletes and coaches, you already know that. That's why I would love to work with you, because you're aware of that, right? You're asking, oh, David, why should I master the mental game? Why should I thrive for mental greatness, inner greatness and that, right? Why should I chase my dream? Well, here it is. You're in a privileged position because you're playing a game, you're playing a sport, and you can experiment. You can see what works and do more of it, and see what doesn't work and do less of it. It's beautiful. But when you really understand on a deep level how you're creating success, and again, having a quiet mind, being at one with your body, listening to your instincts, to your intuition and all that, that means that you can take that understanding then and apply it to all areas of life. You can apply it to your relationships. You can apply it to your business. You can apply it to any hobbies that you have, whatever it is. The principles are the same. That's the first. And the second advantage is that that's for all the coaches out there. If you understand how you're creating success consistently again and again, then you can take that knowledge and you can pass it on to other people. You can pass it on to your team. You can pass it on to your athletes. And that is a very beautiful and empowering and fulfilling thing, because that's what I'm doing. I love serving you. Okay. If this resonates with you, here's what I invite you to do. I want you to book a power session. There's a button just below this video. There's also a bunch of testimonials. There's a button below to book a power session. The power session will be with me. What we're going to do is we're going to have a close look at you, and we're going to identify where you're stuck in terms of your mental game. And we're going to map out how you can overcome that and start winning the mental game of greatness. Okay. And it doesn't matter what sport you play. It doesn't matter on what level you are. It doesn't matter if you're an athlete or a coach. We have the knowledge. We have the systems. We have the support system. And we have the community to help you quiet your mind and start performing under pressure. Okay. You have to understand one thing. I'm answering questions like every day, right? And in fact, if you see this offer, if the button is still there, that means the offer is still valid. It means that I'm going to personally take your call. I'm looking very much forward to that. But I want you to go book that call right now, because you see, I can't work with a million people on this, because it's very hands-on. It's very personal. It's very much about the experiential learning. So sooner or later, I'm going to have to pull the support on this. But it's not going to happen to you, because you're going to be grandfathered in. But I want you to book the session, to do the power session with me as soon as possible, because trust me when I say this is the best thing that I've ever done. It is so holistic. It is so hands-on. You cannot lose. And, you know, it is the only way to perform under pressure is to quiet your mind. It's the only way. And as I mentioned, it's so beautiful because you can take those principles and apply it to all areas of your life. Because again, why do we want to perform under pressure? When people are watching, when it really counts, because we can give more to ourselves, but we can also give more to our teams, to our families, and to everybody who supported and believed in us throughout all the years, right? It's a beautiful win, 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 win. All right. I got nothing but love for you. Peace.